still hear it. But that's fine. Did you want me to go find another room or... Oh, okay. I was saying that to be polite, but honestly, I don't think there is another room. There's someone already passed out upstairs, so I... Believe me, I tried that room, and, yeah, I don't want to be there if he decides to get sick, and, well, I mean, the other rooms are pretty much everyone's playing party, people in the garage, so, well, all in all, I think I chose a good room, considering there's only one other person here. No. I got my drink. Still got some ice left in it. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Yeah. Anyway. Having a good time. It's just, sometimes you just need to, you know, step back and recharge, you know? Which is what I was hoping to do. Yeah. I wonder how late this is gonna be going for. Oh, you got a drink. That's a classic. Generally, it's a little, to have it straight like that is a little strong for me. I mean, unless it's like a shooter. I usually get those like, yes, exactly. Yeah, the weird ones with like the different flavors. Yeah. I saw one in the store the other day. It was something weird. I think it was like bacon flavor. Yeah. Me either. No, I didn't get it. I think the weirdest flavor I've tried is like, was marshmallow. Yeah. It might have been toasted marshmallow. I'm not sure what the difference between toasted and normal marshmallow. I mean, I do know the difference. One is toasted, one exactly. But like flavor-wise, what do they do differently? Yeah, I guess that makes sense. A little more smoky. Yeah, I'm just drinking. I got a bit of wine. I'm not used to being up so late, but for the party, There's no reason why it wouldn't go together. Yeah. So yeah, put a bit of those together. I mean, that's the good thing about wine, right? Well, one of the good things. Yeah, it's just in the fridge. No, I doubt anyone's gonna take it. I mean, if you bring a pack of beer to a party and you put that in the fridge, you know, first, if someone gets the same kind as you, chances are, maybe not chances are, but there is a chance someone might just go ahead and take that, like, not on purpose, or maybe on purpose, because they have plausible deniability, right? Excuse me. But, it would be kind of difficult, I think. First off, who shows up with wine to a party, right? Yeah, I know, you gotta be pretty bougie like me. I mean, I'm just that top tier, high class partier, you know? Show up with a bottle of wine. But like, no one's, yeah. Can you imagine a guy going to the fridge and being like, man, I'm all out of the Mickey I brought, or I'm all out of my six packs done. Like, gotta blend in. Oh, let me just pour some of this wine. And we're like, oh, you brought wine? Yeah, I totally brought wine. And then wine who's I don't know. I feel like that'd be obvious. I mean, if he asked, I'd offer him wine. I have no problem sharing. Go ahead. People are usually pretty generous at parties, you know. I'm assuming you like everything. That's the thing, because everyone has their own mix, right? So I show up to a party with wine. Let's say I don't really drink beer. Yeah, I don't like the taste. Do you? Yeah. See, you're lucky, because I feel like beer is perfect for like summer drinking in the bars and like on the terrace and stuff like that. I don't know, you order a pitcher and it's like real refreshing. You don't have to think or contemplate. You get the glass, you can hang out there for a little bit, and you don't spend a fortune. But yeah, so like, as long as you drink a little bit of everything someone offers you, hey, you like whiskey? Yeah, man, here, let me make you a drink. That actually reminds me, earlier tonight, what's his name? Yes, so he offers me, it wasn't whiskey, but he offers me like rum. He's like, oh, I got this new rum. I was like, really? What's the brand? I forget what the brand was. It was something exotic. Well, from overseas anyway. And he's like, do you want to try it? I was like, oh, for sure. You know, I'm picturing he's going to make me a drink, right? I'm like, oh, he's probably going to mix it with Coke. So he hands me a glass. He's like, here, try this. I taste it. I swear it was like, he mixed rum with some other type of alcohol. I don't know. It just tasted really strong. It could have been like some very neutral, or maybe a very weak mix or strong mix, depending on which one we're talking about. Sorry, I got a little burp. But, jeez, I didn't want to be rude. So I said, I mean, No, I would not throw that away. Yeah. No, I drank it, but I found an excuse to sort of drink it away from his presence. Cause every time I took a sip, I would get that, like, I call it sour face. face where you, your face gets all clenched up. And I didn't want him to think that I hated the drink he made, right? Yeah, exactly. I was just being a nice guy. No, so... yeah. Another thing I like about wine is, it's perfectly portioned, right? Yeah. I mean, you drink the bottle, and that should be it. Yes, I guess, assuming you're not sharing. You are correct in that. Isn't that always the case, though? You're real polite at the start, but by the end, you're like, hey, yeah, I'll have some more shots. Like, yes, let's go. And it always seems to derail. I think the key to being a good partier is to know when to decline an offered drink. And if I may extend this analogy, when to accept it as well. So, because if you're getting past the point of, what's the word I'm looking for? Being able to stand, I guess. If you're getting a little bit past that point, then maybe you should take it easy. However, if the host, is like, hey, let's do a cheers, everyone, then you gotta accept. So you gotta kind of balance it right. Because if you accept too many and then the mandatory cheers accept comes, well, then you might be in trouble, right? But if you decline too many and there is no cheers, well, then guess what? You're out of luck. I don't know if you noticed, but I put my bag down over there. Kind of got a weird request for you, but, I brought some of my stuff. No, I don't know. I might be sleeping over. I haven't decided yet. I guess it depends on the weather outside. If it gets too bad, it's raining a bit right now. But what I was saying was it's a little weird, but I brought a candle. Yes. A candle. Yeah. Yeah, no. I didn't bring it for you. I didn't know you were gonna be in. Well, see, that sounds like it's your problem, not mine. Yes, so, okay. You know what a candle is? That's good. I don't know, usually I just like to, when I'm just chilling out like this, usually on my lonesome, it helps me sort of get in the mood. No, not that kind of mood. Okay, yes, that kind of mood. Yeah, exactly. This kind of mood. Well, it's not lit, so we're not that kind of mood. Okay, it's lit out there. It's not lit in here. You get my vibe? Yes. Look, can I light my damn candle or not? Thank you. There. Hold on, I'm getting my drink. the science behind it, because like what usually burns up, right? But the whole point of a candle is like the wax makes it burn longer. So yeah, I don't know. I feel like it's like, anyway, yeah, I'm not making a lot of sense now, but someone's gonna know what I'm talking about. yes, exactly. Wood makes good sounds. Somewhere. No, I don't smoke. I don't got a lighter. You can give me your... Well, why'd you offer if you don't have one? No, I probably... No, I bring matches. They're just in my bag somewhere. Front pocket. No. No, not that front pocket. No, there's two. No. Okay, stop. Go down. No. Yes. There you go. What do you mean that's not a pocket? What? It doesn't matter if it doesn't have a zipper. It's still a pocket. Well, what do you mean? It's just matches. It's not gonna... Well, I don't know. I don't think I was pretty sure the rain wouldn't get through the fabric, okay? Well, I just threw it in. I grabbed it because... Oh, what's that? Oh. Someone just messaged me. Oh. Yeah, he's wondering. He's wondering where I went. Nah, it's good. Just checking in on me. That should be fine. I'll just message him back. No biggie. Let's see. Said, no, I'm just downstairs, hanging out. I'll be back soon. That was nice of him. Thank you. Got our matches. That's what I was talking about before when you called me a crazy person about the wig. It's pretty chill, right? Pretty relaxing. I know. I used to have trouble lighting matches, actually. something. No. Well, I don't know. They don't give them to you, but, like, I guess as a kid with my parents, I used to, like, see them on the table and play with. Exactly. No, I don't think I was a pyromaniac. So, you were. I never did that, but I would just, like, let them burn, right? And blow them out. Well, one time, I don't even know where I saw this, but, like, I have this, like, image of someone, like, licking their thumb and their pointer finger, and then, like, pinching, like, the wick of a candle. Or like a match to like snuff it out really quickly, right? And I thought maybe possibly a candle, and I thought that was like really cool. But so I wanted to try that one time, but I did it with a match, right? And I mean, I could be wrong because I never tried it again afterwards. Yeah, but I feel like a match burns hotter than like a candle wick. Anyway, I think what you're supposed to do is just like snuff it out and let go. But I like held it, right? And like I burnt like my fingertip. And anyway, yeah, I learned my lesson. Watching a candle flame. Are you into any like meditation or anything like that? A little bit. Well, apparently there's a type of meditation where you just focus like intensely on the flame of a candle. Have you heard it? No. Well, you should try it. I had a little trouble doing it, but it was still pretty cool, all the same. And if you focus on it intently enough, the candle, like try to zoom in on the flame, right? Like, right where it's burning, with, like, both your eyes, and try to ignore, your periphery vision. And if you do that for long enough, there's kind of like an optical illusion, sort of like the whole room gets darker, and like you kind of get like a tunnel vision, as if you're looking through a tube. Yeah, okay. You kind of get tube vision. Are you happy? Yeah. So you kind of get tube vision, and everything like darkens, and as soon as you like move your eyes a tiny bit, like unfocus from the flame, it's like everything like brightens up again. It's kind of trippy. Did you want to try to do that real quick? Here. Yeah. And just focus on that one. Honestly, I don't know how far you have to be. Yeah, try to be like, no, a bit farther. Yeah, like that. Focus. About a minute, I would say, or longer. It's more effective if you don't. Actually, no, don't stare at the wick. Try to stare like, not like the middle of the flame, like a bit, not the tip, because the tip moves too much, right? So like above the wick, kind of like in the center. Like in the heart of the flame. Because if you're too close, maybe a foot, 2 feet, then the light will be like everywhere in your eyes, right? You won't have any periphery. You want to try it again? Everyone's still there. Maybe one person. Wasn't it? Yeah, it really sets the mood. outside. Take a walk. Looks like it stopped raining. Yeah, it's really clear out. You can see a lot of the stars. That sucks. If it wasn't raining, we could probably have been outside on the porch. That's true. Yeah, then maybe there'd be more free rooms with everyone outside, right? There's a bunch of loud music going on. Oh, well, I'll find him. I don't know, do the cats like rain? I don't think you would go outside. Some do, I guess. I know, he's probably under a couch. Yeah, same. I don't have any, but I like them. Both cats and dogs. Sometimes it can be a lot of responsibility. Snacks in my bag if you are hungry. Or was that a joke? No, for sure I do. Not in the bottom pocket. No. In the main one. I don't know, I brought some granola bars. Not specifically for this, but I usually have them in there. Just pull them out of the drawer. I made them appear out of thin air. scissors, thank you very much. It's see, you ripped all yours, and now you got that little piece that you ripped off. What are you gonna do with that? You're gonna pocket it. You're gonna forget it if you leave it there. This way. Exactly, I just opened my granola bar with an antique pair of scissors. I was gonna say, when I pack them for work, I usually put everything in the fridge, like with my my water and like my yogurt and whatnot. So I just put everything together. So when I eat the granola bar, it's usually been sitting in the fridge for like, I don't know what, 4 or 5 hours. Very firm. This gives me an impression it's freshly baked. I don't know. I don't think you would. Onto something. I'm craving that right now. Something hot. What are you doing? No, I don't have any ramen in my bag. I wonder what time the place closes. Thank you. 6 minutes. We missed it by 6 minutes. Jeez. If you hit, it's your fault. No, because you spent like 6 minutes naming other types of food. Yes, you did. I counted. No, I timed. Slowly, I was just timing. Well, I guess if they closed, how does that work? I assume maybe they stopped delivering before they close as well. Because if they close at 11, then maybe they stopped delivering at 10 or something anyway. So maybe we missed it by like an hour and 6 minutes. Sounds good.
No, no, no.